Are you someone who changes? If you're with this person, if you're with that person, you act this way, or maybe you talk like this here, but not here. Or maybe you, you know, are allow yourself to do certain things with these people, but not with these people. The way you compromise can be different from the way I compromise. You want to fit in. You want to be accepted. You want people to care about you. You want people to think you're funny, or you want people to think you're so smart, or that you have it all together, or whatever it may be. So you continue to compromise. Maybe it's gossip. Maybe it's sex. Maybe it's hiding. Maybe it's lying. Maybe it's telling things that aren't true so that people believe stories. Or, I mean, the list can go on and on, the way that we compromise. It could be the words you say. It could be the thoughts that you think. And we think that it works. See, that's the snare, that's the trap, is that we think it actually is getting us in and it's actually working, but sin is never safe. In the end, there's always repercussions relationally with people and relationally with God. So today I just want to encourage you not to compromise who you are in Christ and what God has called you to in order to fit in. The fear of man lays a snare, but whoever trusts in the Lord is safe. The integrity of the upright guides them, but the crookedness of the treacherous destroys them. May integrity and uprightness preserve me, for I wait for you. What does the scripture say? That those who fear the Lord are safe. Those who obey the Lord are safe. We want to have a life that is characterized by the blessing of God's protection and safety, and we need to be walking in a way that God wants to bless and God wants to bring safety on, not in a sinfully compromising way. Have you recently put yourself in an ensnaring, tangled up mess because you're changing and compromising your character so that you can fit in with other people? It literally breeds like a web of messy craziness whenever we're living that way. So just think about your life and think about the actions that you've taken to create that. Why did it seem like a good idea, and what's the truth? Was it a good idea? Does God say it's a good idea? Does it bring safety? All right, now let's think about something that you did well. When have you been tempted to compromise, but instead you said, you know what? No, I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna say what I should say. I'm gonna be who I should be. I'm gonna honor the Lord in everything that I am, instead of giving into this temptation just so somebody can accept me or like me or think my life's cool online or whatever it may be. When have you done that well lately? So Proverbs 29:6 says that an evil man is ensnared in his sin, but a righteous man sings praises. So just take time to worship the Lord and let that worship fill your heart and fill your mind, so that when these opportunities comes up, you're so full in your mind and your heart of just like the goodness of God that you wouldn't want to do anything to compromise giving him glory.